tell you something about your servant. You're serving on pretentious stuff. He's trying to tell you you have a purpose. He called us for a purpose, and that purpose is ripe and fast. He's saying there's too many of us wearing our love on our sleeve. He's saying our heart is too easily crumbled. When it should have what? It should be patient. It should be kind. Those are the things that the Lord is requiring of our hearts. But because it's Thanksgiving, we will hide behind that banner. You can't come to my house at Thanksgiving because we're not friends. Even though I'm celebrating Christ, oh my God. Even though I'm celebrating, listen now, I'm celebrating giving thanks at Thanksgiving. By the way, the Indians, why they started it was for the new friends. Why did the Indians set up Thanksgiving? I know it is history, so I don't just speak the Bible. They were celebrating their new friends, weren't they?
Oh my God.
Fellowship. Listen now, a ship carries people. Oh my God. You became the vessel to carry the love of Jesus at your table. By the way, he said, thou preparest or what? In the presence of who?
Of my enemy.
But when they sit at your table, they become what? Oh my God. They become your friend when they sit at your table. Listen now. Now, Jesus is about to eat. What you're about to do to me tomorrow is not going to stop you from getting this blessing right now. What you're about to do to me right now is not going to stop who I am or what the Lord's about to bless me with. By the way, I can't hate you because if I do, it disturbs my prayer from getting what? Come on. Am I worth you missing the train to heaven? Am I worth you missing your greatest blessing? When all you need to do is love me through the mess that I'm in. You know, my wife said, her first lady used to tell her, I would love the hell out of you. Oh my God. Let me say it again. I would love the hell out of you. My God. I don't care what you did to me. Jesus is saying, and maybe about to teach a lesson. How many of us can teach a lesson to our enemy? Come on, you don't want to do that. As a matter of fact, what we want is for you to get as far away from me as possible. Okay, that's not true. Thank God. I got some real Christians in here. Well, let me show you why Jesus said it's not true. What did he say? What was the lesson he wrote to us?
Read, yes. And he answered and said, that he that dipped his hand in there, the same with me, shall betray me. The son of
man. You know what he said, right? Family member.
Somebody close to me.
Oh, my God. Who do you want to betray you? What is a betrayal all about? Can a perfect stranger betray you?
No.
Come on, y'all. Can a perfect stranger betray you?
No.
No, because they don't know you, so it won't be betrayal. Oh, my God. It's someone that's right there that you trusted. Come on, some of us went through divorce because we betrayed.
Come on.
But here's what we think. You betrayed me. How about they betrayed themselves and God first betrayed you?
Oh, my God.
Before we kill them, how about knowing about their humanity first? Yeah. Hallelujah. Before you run down to the divorce man, how about grace and mercy? That's what I tell you, you got to invite who first?
Jesus
first to your table. Because you might find out at your table, you're sitting with some real enemies of people who don't like you. Do you know people can eat your food at Thanksgiving and still dislike you?
Yeah.
I dare you to ask somebody, who do they say that I am?
My God.
At your table. My God. Now tell me, why did Jesus go through, sit and have a meal, a Passover meal? By the way, you know what the Passover meal meant, right? He was celebrating freedom.